Julie. It's really nice to see you. How are you?
I'm fine, Abigail. It's lovely to see you as well today.
Good. So I'm really glad that you're here to talk to us about managing mental health, because I think it's been clear for quite some time how important managers are in promoting and supporting good mental health at work. And given the current situation, this is now even more important. In your role as a manager, Julie, what do you think managers and your colleagues can do to best support staff wellbeing at this time?
I would say the most important thing is don't assume. You know, if you're a good manager, you should know your people, but you'll know your people through different circumstances. You know, a lot of your people may be working from home now, they're working in a different environment. And those people who normally may not have issues with their mental health may actually be really struggling at the moment. So don't assume that all of your team are fine. But also don't assume that some of them aren't okay, because you'd be surprised. Some people actually are dealing with this situation a lot better and are even surprising themselves. So it's just being taken into account that we're all working under quite challenging times. Some of us are having to juggle the lovely homeschooling alongside doing their working. Some people are having to care for loved ones. Some people are really anxious about that. They may be shielding people that they love. Some of them may be on their own and may just be, you know, working in an environment where actually the only interaction they're having is through work. So the first thing is don't assume that all of your people are okay or that all of your people aren't.
Okay, yeah, really good advice there. So it's about respecting that everybody's going to have a slightly different approach, a slightly different experience of this. And I guess it's about having those conversations and checking out with people how they are. And when people are working remotely, you mentioned that just previously, how can we spot those signs? You know, encourage managers to look out for the signs with staff. What is it that we can see with our staff when they're working remotely?
So I think the first thing is how you communicate with your people. So video is brilliant. You know, how technology has really helped us during this current situation is fantastic. So if you've got people that you can do video calls with, that's brilliant, because you can tell a lot more about somebody by their body language. It will also help you when you start having those regular conversations, and especially when you're starting with that general question with how are things with you. If you can see the person, you can see how they're reacting. Even if they're saying, oh, everything's okay, you'll be able to tell with their body language. But you need to be mindful that not everybody is comfortable with video calls. You know, some of us don't like that. So, you know, work with your people. So again, if you're just dealing with them from a verbal point of view, you can take those cues by their voice. You'll, again, like I said, you should know your people. So when you're saying, how are you today? And you feel that they're not letting you in, you can do a bit of, you know, so for example, I might say to my staff, do you know, I'm finding this really hard too. And I think if you come across as, you know, we're all in this together, that may help somebody open up. The other thing as well that's really good is just letting your people know that there are other channels that they can talk to.
Yeah.
So, you know, the biggest group of people is your peers. So, you know, encouraging your people. Are you talking to your work colleagues? Are you talking to your friends at work? And hopefully that will help. If people don't feel comfortable talking to you because you're a manager, at least they've got another area. We also know that there's some companies out there that have got mental health first aiders. So again, if you've got those in your company, making sure that your people know that that is a route, using mental health first aiders or employee assistance programs, they are really useful. Or those of you that are from a trade union background, there's trade union reps, HR professionals. So there are loads of avenues that you can set with your people. And I think the other thing is, when you're having those conversations, setting clear expectations and boundaries. Yes, we are working in different times and some people are still going out to work, and again, having those conversations with them, but we are working differently. So we're not expecting our people to do everything that they normally do when this situation's not happening. So setting clear boundaries and expectations is good for both of you, because for your people, they'll have a good idea of what you're expecting from them at the moment, especially if they're juggling a load of other things in the background. You know, so if you've got someone who's doing homeschooling, you're not going to be expecting them to be performing to the 100% level as what they normally would do. And have that conversation with them. Ask them, what can they achieve? Make them feel valued and make them see how what contribution they are making is a fantastic contribution. And again, that's good from a mental health point of view, because it makes that individual feel really positive about themselves while they're struggling and juggling quite a lot of stuff.
Yeah. So there's quite a useful piece there for managers about how they speak to people, about how they equally make sure the people who they manage are aware of all those different routes to support, because sometimes it's not easy for people to go to their manager. So we know that managers, lots of great managers really want to help their staff. They're familiar with the signs and they go to a member of staff and they raise that, you know, like you said, how are you? Or I've noticed things aren't quite right with you. And the member of staff still maybe says, I'm fine, you know, everything's okay. And maybe because they don't want to acknowledge that they're struggling, or maybe because there's lots of other things that are going on for them. Is there any other particular advice that you'd give to managers about keeping in touch with people when people haven't quite acknowledged that they're not feeling quite themselves?
I think it's about having those regular check-ins, but it's also take a step back and how would you normally deal with that member of staff if they're not being as forthcoming as they normally would? Because like I say, your line management skills do not need to change. So you know your people better than anybody else. So what would you normally do? What mechanisms would you normally take if you feel that that person's not being so forthcoming? And again, I think by actually sharing a bit of yourself when you're having those conversations, telling them about, I'm finding it hard as well. Or actually go on to a bit of a lighter subject first of all. So rather than going straight into a conversation about work, why don't you start with, you know, if it's a Monday morning or Tuesday, if it's their first day, and how was your weekend? Have you had, how are things at home? What have you been doing? What are you watching? Are you watching anything on the telly? You know, are there things, what other activities you're doing? So starting a normal conversation to actually relax that other individual before you then move on to, let's talk about work and let's talk about things that you're doing. So again, we know if you can relax, first of all, it's a good way of doing it.
And in terms of, you've talked about keeping in touch with people and you've talked about the teams who work around you. And I just wondered, around that human connection, around that sort of general chat and that more relaxed environment, what have you and your teams been doing to keep in touch with each other in that way?
So one of the things we're doing is we're having virtual tea breaks. So we're Skyping in. And again, that's up to people whether they want to interact or not. Not everybody has to talk. And actually, if we think about those chats you have in the office, a couple of you may chat around someone's desk. And actually, there may be other people that are actually working as you're having that chat, but they're interacting. So again, when you're doing those virtual chats, not everybody has to speak, because hearing laughter can also cheer people up. So that's a good thing. We're also doing things around doing quizzes. Some teams I know that are doing things in an evening as well, so our after work, just catching up and doing a bit of social, if that's something you can do. But there's a variety of stuff that I'm hearing that's happening, not just in Acas but in other organisations. And I think the other thing as well is being mindful that not everybody is at work. Some people are furloughed, and it's also important that line managers are keeping in touch. So the things I'm hearing from some employers that are in those situations is they're doing regular weekly web chats, getting the team together, or something as simple as a group WhatsApp and having regular contact with people who are furloughed, just so they feel part of the organisation. It's exactly the same as we would do normally should we have someone who's away from work because of maternity leave, or if someone's on a career break, or someone's are, off on long-term sick. You know, we would always encourage at ACAS that you should keep regular contact with that person. So again, it shouldn't be any different if your staff are furloughed at the minute, or if your staff are staying at home because they're shielding, because they've got an underlying health condition. It's that same contact to have with that individual, so they feel valued, they feel connected with the organisation. Because again, we know if you feel connected, it's better for your mental health because you feel part of something. So it's just as critical, just about people who are working, but also your people that may be having to spend some time at home at the moment for a variety of different reasons.
Yeah, I think that's a really good point. So actually, because what we're encouraging businesses to think about is, what do they do normally? What will they do in normal circumstance? How do they keep in touch? And how do they adapt that or adjust that to the current climate, really? Because I know that people are also starting to talk about going back to work, you know, and I'm just wondering what your thoughts are about how you would, if you had maybe a team member who was concerned about that, how you would talk to them about that.
Do you know what, Abigail? I think for a lot of people out there, this is a really scary time at the moment. And we're all at different stages in that. So some of us may already be back at work. Some of us may be due to be going back to work. And as managers, we need to be mindful that not everybody is going to be happy about this. You know, a lot of us are really frightened. You've got to think about, how are your people coming into work? Are they using public transport? Are they going to be walking to work? Are they going to be, you know, doing other means to get into the office or into the workplace? They're also going to be nervous about what the setup's going to be, you know. So how are you going to be making sure that they're safe and they're protected? What PPE, what social distancing are you doing? And I think the key message is to get across to your people is, your safety is our priority. So, and explaining to them what measures you're putting in place, but also asking again your people, have you got any questions, have you got any concerns, what can I do to make this journey or this transition easier for you? I can't take everything away, but what can I do to make that easier for you? Because again, everyone will be different. So don't assume that just because this group of people are okay, that everybody will be okay with the changing situation.
Yeah, absolutely. So health, safety and well-being are really, really key into how we transition people back into work and have those conversations. And I'm aware that we're talking about people and we're talking about staff and we're talking about that, but managers are people and staff. And I'm just wondering, you know, how you as a manager or your management colleagues, what they're doing to keep themselves well and make sure that they maintain their boundaries and make sure that they keep themselves well during this time.
So I think one of the first key things we need to remember as managers, we are people as well. And I think it's remembering that you cannot help others if you're not helping yourself. It's like the oxygen mask scenario. You know, you'd always put your mask on first before somebody else because you're no good to anyone. So it's about making sure that you look after your own health and your own mental health during this time. From a personal point of view, I'm finding that chocolate is really helping. but actually, being able to talk to your peers, you know, I'm really lucky at ACAS. I work alongside a fantastic leadership team and I can talk to them and they talk to me and we make sure that we look after each other. So, but it's also being able to recognise that you will not have all the answers. This, you know, some of the things that have happened since this pandemic, there are things that we never would have imagined we'd have to do, and you're not expected to know the answers. But I think it's proved to us as human beings how versatile we are, how we've been able to adapt to different situations. So I think it's, you know, don't beat yourself up if you don't know the answer. If you're dealing with an issue, remember that you can always go and get advice yourself. So again, I talked about mental health first aiders earlier on, and if you've got those in your organisations, they're not just for you if you need advice for your own mental health, they're there as a resource for line managers as well. Yeah. Or if you've got staff networks, again, fantastic resource, they're there to advise you. So again, make sure that you go to them for advice, but look after yourself and be kind to yourself. give yourself a break. And like I say, it is hard at the moment, but laughter is another thing that's got me through as a line manager. So again, when you're having those virtual catch-ups with your team, adding some fun into that, again, will do you good as well as your people.
Excellent. Excellent advice. So I think laughter, chocolate and kindness are what I'm going to take away from this discussion.
Definitely.
Okay. And we know that kindness is the theme for Mental Health Awareness Week this year, so even more pertinent. Okay. Thank you very much for your time, Julie. Take care.
Take care. Bye.
Bye.